supposed to be, it's April 8th. You know, they're talking about the eclipse, but I'm meeting some very wonderful people like Slim right here. Say hey, Slim. Okay, so, but the gentleman inside the washateria, he just told me he wants to talk to me. He's going to tell me something that he does not tell people typically. He said, but the Lord told him to tell me something. I don't know. I felt like I needed to record this. Okay, so this is the beautiful gentleman I was just mentioning. Okay, so I'm so eager to find out. He says, just a second.
1 minute.
1 minute.
First of all, we need to be open mind.
Okay.
Second thing is you need to be patient.
Okay. Open-minded and patient.
Open-minded and patient.
Okay.
Open-minded, that means when Jesus comes to knock the door,
yes,
of your heart,
yes,
and you don't open, he cannot come in your heart.
Oh,
he cannot come in. You get to open your heart.
Okay.
And you listen. And he comes to you. And I will share with you the incredible story that helped you a lot today. After you open the door, get out, that will, it may change your life. That may help you a lot of things. And with my humble, my love,
wow,
my humble, I share with you. I don't share with many people. I only share with people open-minded. Because I tell them, they shut up. They, I cannot change their life.
No.
So I only share with some people, and they listening, and they learning, and they want to learn something about their life. And I have many stories and surprise you.
Well, and thank you for choosing me. And you know, thank
I don't
you.
Choose you. Maybe the Lord choose you.
Oh, indeed.
I don't choose you. Don't tell me. I don't tell you I am a good person. No, I'm not a good person. I don't tell you I am the reborn Christian. No. I don't tell you I am the smart person. No. Don't confuse about me. Don't confuse. Please, don't confuse about me. I am the ordinary people like you.
Yes, sir.
So I'm very humble to tell you. So don't misunderstand. Don't misunderstand. Oh, he's the good man. No. Don't confuse me. Don't think about, oh, this guy, very nice. No. Don't confuse me at all. But I share you the story and you will learn. Ma'am, look
yes.
at the picture.
Yes, sir.
You see two dimples?
I do.
Okay, now, I feel beginning my story.
Okay.
With the Lord, I tell you the true story from my heart. With the Holy Spirit, I tell you the truth. I don't know why I tell you. I don't know what you learn after I tell you, but I believe you learn something when I share with you with my humble and my love. When my wife gets pregnant about 3 months or 4 months, and you know, you are the woman, you may have children. And in that time, we don't go ultrasound, right?
Right.
Because you, after 4 months, 5 months, we can go ultrasound to know we had a boy or a girl. I have a dream. I saw the girl about 4-5 years old. She wear the white dress. And she stand at me, smile at me with two dimples. I woke up. I told my wife, honey, this time we have a girl with two dimples. I tell you, the people can guess 50-50. Boy, girl, boy. It's nothing. nothing, you know, nothing specific, nothing, nothing like the other people. True or false, guy, girl or boy, yes or no, that not nothing, you know. But to me, I told you, I told my wife, we have a girl with two nipples. And I tell you, I met every people. I met with my minister. He laughed at me. He said, Tom, we are Christians. Don't believe something, you know. I say to my minister, I say, sir, the truth is a truth. The truth is a truth, not Christian, not Buddhist. No. Don't confuse. The truth is the truth. I just tell you, it's the truth. I will have the girl with two dimples. One day, in my family, we have the dinner, and my brother, he's the Christian. He's in the church. Mm-hmm. I forget the name by English, but mm-hmm. I will tell you. Mm-hmm. And he told me, he laughed at me when I tell my family. I tell my family, look, at that time my wife get pregnant. 6 months or something, but we don't go ultrasound. I told my wife, don't need to go ultrasound. And he said at me, he said, Tom, we are Christian. You don't believe something, you know, beyond the Christian. I say, brother, you don't believe what I said to you? He said, yeah, I don't believe you. I said, bet $500. You don't believe? Bet $500. You know why? Why you don't bet $500? He don't bet. He shut up his mouth and, you know. When my wife delivering my daughter named Gina, she the doctor in Austin right now, in Dale Hospital. She the doctor right now.
Beautiful.
And I tell you, the nurse, I stand out the door of the delivery room. And when the nurse carry Zina to me, she say, Tom, this is your daughter. She hand the daughter to me. I grab up her in my arm. And she cry, and I saw two dimples. I tell you, my hair stood up like this.
Yeah.
I get shocked from here to here, from here to here, from here to here.
Huh.
I tell you, ma'am, first of all, I tell you, I'm not the Buddhist. First of all, I tell you, I am the Christian. But I tell you, ma'am, I don't know. But to me, I believe somehow the law, some people die, and the law, he can decide everything he want to do. In his
yes.
He can decide, he want this, he want this, he want that. He decide everything.
Yes.
And he say, baby, come back to Tom's family. He decide, I don't know, man. Today I am about to tell you. I don't know, but I know is there is something with afterlife.
Yes.
There is something we die. We don't mean at the end. Something else. Something else.
Yes.
So I tell you, man, from that day, it changed my life 180 degrees. I tell you, I'm not the good man. I'm not a reborn Christian. I'm not the... But to me, there is something after life. After the day, we see the Lord, and He will judge, He will guide me, He will do something I don't know. So, ma'am, we with my humble, I share with me my story, the true 100% from the Lord today with you.
And it's
there
beautiful.
Is something that the death is not the end. There is something else. And
yes.
I don't know. Because just like that, with my humble, I share with you and God bless you and your family.
Oh my God. Thank you so, so very much. You know, I believe you that there's something next, and we're so close to the end of the world as we know it, as we know it. You know, we're getting really close to that. There's something different about today. It's spiritual. That's why I met you, and that's why you have acted as a messenger and gave me a beautiful message to share with whomever will watch this video. I thank you so, so very kindly, because you are, whether you say so or not, you are a beautiful being whom, according to Jeremiah 1:5, the Lord knew you before he placed you in your mother's womb, and he saved you to the end, because typically people do save the best to last. And you are among the best. Thank you. You're a beautiful servant, sir.
I want to share you something now. Let me take you.
Yes, sir.
During about 2 or 3 years ago, I had 7 accidents.
Wow.
I escaped 7 accidents. Don't think about I may have depressed, I hit, no, they hit me 7 times. They hit me on the road. Mm. They hit me, I drive carefully. Before I go, I pray to the Lord. When I get home, I pray to the Lord. I thank the Lord.
Mm.
But the people hit me 7 times, ma'am. 7 times, not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, let me tell you, may I say something to you?
Yes, ma'am.
I got to say this because I'm on my way to an interview. I never would interrupt you otherwise, okay? But I must say, just listening to you, all you're really confirming is that no weapon formed against you will prosper. The enemy wanted to get rid of you because you keep spreading light like you did today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for the light you spread. Really quickly. No weapon formed against you will prosper. No, it won't work. No weapon formed against you will prosper. No. It won't work. God will do what he said he will do. He'll stand by his word. He'll see you through. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. No, it will never work.